Today, I want to walk you through something that every single person needs to know. What does a heart attack really feel like? Because what you've seen in the movies, someone clutching their chest and collapsing, is only one version of the truth. And if you or someone you love experiences a heart attack, it may look very different. If you're new here, I'm Hafiz, a cardiologist training in London. I started creating videos to increase awareness of heart disease so you can lead a healthier life. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, so you'll be the first to watch my videos when they come out. So let's dive straight in. Heart attack symptoms vary from person to person. The classical symptom of a heart attack is chest pain or discomfort that happens suddenly and doesn't go away. People often describe the sensation as a weight or a tightness or like an elephant sitting on the chest. The pain can spread to the left or right arm or to your neck, jaw or back or even to your stomach. There can be other associated symptoms like shortness of breath, nausea or cold sweats. You can even feel dizzy or lightheaded. It's also possible to have a heart attack without experiencing all these symptoms, and it's important to remember everyone experiences pain differently. Some people may not experience the pain as much. This is more likely in elderly people or people with diabetes, as the condition can cause nerve damage, which affects how you feel pain. Heart attack symptoms in women can differ from those in men, which unfortunately leads to women being more frequently misdiagnosed. This is primarily the result of various misconceptions, including the widespread view that cardiovascular disease affects men more than it does women. However, it's important to know that cardiovascular disease is still the most common cause of death in women worldwide. So what's exactly happening in your heart during a heart attack? Most heart attacks are caused by coronary heart disease. Coronary heart disease causes your coronary arteries, which is the blood supply to your heart, to become narrowed by a gradual buildup of fatty deposits called atheroma. A heart attack is caused when blood flow to part of your heart gets blocked. If a piece of atheroma breaks off, a blood clot forms around this to try and repair the damage to the artery wall. This clot can block your coronary artery, causing your heart muscle to be starved of blood and oxygen. Without enough blood and oxygen, your heart can be seriously damaged. Other less common causes of a heart attack include spontaneous coronary artery dissection, which is when a tear appears on the wall of one of your coronary arteries. Harmful drugs like cocaine can also cause a heart attack due to coronary spasm, which can block blood flow to the heart muscle. And a sudden drop in oxygen levels in the body called hypoxia can also lead to a heart attack. So what do you do if you or someone who is with you is having a heart attack? Firstly, it's really important you get medical attention immediately. Don't worry about wasting paramedics' time. A heart attack is a medical emergency. You should call for an ambulance, sit down and stay calm, wait for the ambulance to arrive, and for the paramedics to assess you. Every minute counts here. The earlier you get treatment, the more heart muscle we can save. In the ambulance, the team will do an electrocardiogram or an ECG to measure the electrical activity of your heart. This is an important test to find out if you're having a heart attack. If the ECG shows you're having a heart attack, you'll be taken to a specialist center to get the best treatment. Whether or not the ECG confirms a heart attack, you'll need further tests to find out what's going on. These tests may include an assessment of your symptoms and medical history, physical examinations, including measuring your blood pressure and monitoring your heart rhythm and heart rate, blood tests to see if there's been any damage to your heart muscle, including a troponin blood test. I've done a whole video explaining this blood test in detail, so check it out later. You may also have an echocardiogram, which is an ultrasound of your heart. I've also done a video on this test, and I'll link to it somewhere on the screen. The aim of the treatment is to get the blood flowing to your heart muscles again as quickly as possible. This can reduce the amount of permanent damage to your heart and save your life. Many people need to have emergency treatment to restore the blood flow. Emergency treatment may include coronary angioplasty, which involves putting one or more stents, which are like small pieces of scaffolding, into the narrowed or blocked artery to keep it open and improve the blood supply to the heart. In some cases, although this is now not as common, is to give thrombolysis. This involves giving you clot-busting medicine to dissolve the blood clot that's blocking the coronary artery. The other option is coronary bypass surgery. This helps to bring back normal blood flow by attaching a blood vessel from your leg, arm, or chest in your heart to go around the blocked artery. You'll discuss with your doctor about which of these treatments might be best for you. It's important to remember that heart attacks don't come out of nowhere. Your body often gives early warning signs, even weeks in advance. You might feel breathless when you're walking up a hill or running for the train. You may have experienced chest discomfort that comes and goes, unexplained fatigue, struggling to do exercise which you didn't find so difficult before, or even palpitations or dizziness. If you're experiencing these symptoms, especially with risk factors like blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, or a smoking history, get yourself checked out. That's why risk factor screening is so important and not just waiting for symptoms to happen. I've done a whole video telling you what I think are the top 5 tests for your heart to address these risk factors, so check it out later. Have you or someone you know had a heart attack? Tell me in the comments below what symptoms you felt. If you've learned something today, share this video with someone you care about. You might just save a life. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.